intellect that concern some of our children. We got troublesome students who constantly disrupt the flow of education. And then there are others who seem beyond reaching. Sometimes teachers dismiss problem students as hopeless and focus their attention on those who want to learn something. And once any student accepts the designation of hopeless, they don't improve, they only get worse. Because if the mama's in the house saying, you're just like your no good dad, and if the teacher's saying you're dumb and you ain't gonna never know nothing, and if adult around him saying you just a bad apple, it won't be long before he starts acting accordingly. That there's nothing more dangerous or troublesome in a school environment than a hopeless student. Hopeless students are not intimidated by your threats. Suspension ain't nothing but vacation. Expulsion, so what? They fail it anyway. It's no big deal for the student who has given up hope on being anything else except a criminal. The only solution is to inspire hope. And this can't be accomplished electronically or by any artificial means. It's got to come from the heart and the soul of the educators. Students got to sense that somebody believes in them. That's why coaches have more influence over students than even some parents. And so for many, the coach is the one source of hope that they know. And God asked Ezekiel the question, can these bones live? And the answer was yes.
Oh yes, thank you.
Not only do we have dry bones in our school, but there are millions of couples that are enduring what they feel are dry bone relationships. Are y'all gonna pray for me? Yeah. These are marriages, these are relationships that are only a shell of what they once were. Some marriages have reached the point where there's little, if any, communication between spouses. Many of them share the same address, but they're living in different rooms. They're just hanging on out tradition or for the benefit of children, but they'll even drive on friendships. Yeah. Friendships that ain't going nowhere because they're going in different directions and each is inconsiderate of the feeling and the needs of others. And so you end up with hurt feelings, jealousy, tears, and frustration. Can such a relationship be sound? Can they live again? Can they enjoy the happiness, the fun, and companionship they once knew? Any fire can be rekindled if they got a few coals now. And where there is love, there is hope. Why? Because in love there is God, and God is love. Invisible to the naked eye, but love is a powerful reality. Where there is love, there is hope. Because love endures. Love hopes all things. Love endures all things. Can these dry bones live again? If they hear the word of the Lord. Lastly, not only do we have dry bones in our school, dry bones in our relationship, but notice, I've lately noticed a bunch of dry bones in the church. They're going through what I call ritualism. They sing the songs, they read the scripture, they know when to stand, they know when to sit. But however, ritualism is not a substitute for spirituality. They know him through their daily relationship, but God is more than a meaningless tradition, but he's a living presence. And when that happens, when you go into ritual, your entire religious experience is reduced to a ritual. But the man or the woman who feeds the hungry senses God's presence in every bowl of food. There's a sense of mission in every kind act done in the name of the Lord. There is closeness to the divine that is developed from carrying out the divine will. Those who distance themselves from living out the mission of the Lord usually experience a reduced spirituality. Oh, they don't make noise. They don't say amen. They don't make a pretense in the worship. They make plenty of smoke, but seldom do you ever see the fire. Can these bones live? If they hear the word of the Lord. And we got to remember that their bones don't dry. They can live again. Ezekiel was asked the question whether the bones in the valley could live again. He said, Lord, you know. And despite his dismay at the miserable estate of the bones, Ezekiel knew that even dry bones can live again. It just needs a word from the Lord. And what was told to Ezekiel is that the people could be restored. But you got to repent. And you got to hear the word of the God. And then you got to act on it. And when they heard the word of the Lord, they were able to live again. And I come by to tell you this morning, Asia, no matter how hopeless the situation appears, things change when you get a word from the Lord. I said a family that may seem on the verge of destruction changes when they get a word from the Lord. A relationship that is on the rocks can get a reprieve when they get a word from the Lord. The key for the dry bone was to hear the word of the Lord. Is there anybody here looking for a fresh start? Is there anybody here looking for forgiveness from God? Then hear the word of the Lord. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins, and I'm going to heal their land. Hear the word of the Lord. Anybody feeling alone? Lo, I'll be with you always until the end of the world. Anybody dealing with trouble in hell and high water? When you pass through the waters, I'm going to be with you. And the rivers, they won't overflow you. And when you walk in the fire, they won't burn you. Folk bringing the dry bone, tell them I'm forgetting those things which are behind me. And I'm reaching forward to those things which are before me. I come by to tell you, hear the word of the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Hear the word of the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want.